NetSuite was designed to streamline and automate ordering through vendor payment, all within an integrated suite. I'm now logged in as the purchasing manager to walk you through how the platform streamlines the procurement process. This is my pre-configured dashboard that is purpose-built and leverages leading practices across thousands of companies, and it contains reminders, shortcuts, and key metrics necessary for me to perform my job. Here you can see reminders for items that require me to take action, which includes all items that need to be ordered. Here, I can see what items I should reorder based upon specified reorder points. Let's order more iPads from our US 1 location to get our inventory levels back up where we want them. With the click of a button, NetSuite has automatically created a purchase order for these items without any data entry. The purchase order will be sent automatically to the vendor via the preference we have detailed on the vendor record, which is usually an email. You can receive the items directly off the purchase order, but we can also find shortcuts to the same information from the dashboard. Now that I've ordered more iPads and created a new PO, I'll see it in my reminders portlet under Orders to Receive. If I have multiple orders to receive, I can receive them in bulk through this reminder. But for now, let's look at the purchase order we just created. Here, I can see the items related to this purchase order and can receive these items right from the PO. On the item receipt, I can select the location and quantity of items I want to receive. I can do partial receipts in the case of an incomplete shipment. This helps me control what I receive and keeps inventory levels at my locations accurate. Now that we've received this order, I am going to take on the AP analyst role to process the vendor bill and payment. My dashboard as an AP analyst looks different from the purchasing manager, as I have different tasks and metrics that are important to me. I have a different list of reminders, including purchase orders to bill, bills to pay, and invoices due. From this screen, I can create bills in bulk or select a few or just one. Note how NetSuite streamlines the data and pushes the information through versus forcing me to rekey any information. As I save this, a vendor bill will be created and my AP aging will be updated in real time to reflect the new bill. My dashboard will also be updated. By drilling into my current AP aging report, you can see the vendor bill. As you can see from the report, I can drill straight into the detail level. All reports in NetSuite are drillable, so I can continue to drill down to the source transaction from this report. There are multiple ways in NetSuite to pay vendor bills. One way is to make a payment straight from the vendor bill itself. Notice how I can handle bulk bill payments, but I will process the specific transaction we've been working with. The vendor bill is now paid. Finally, I'd like to take a look at the vendor record to get a complete view of activities for MicroShop. From the vendor record, I can get a view of all the transaction history by clicking on the Vendor 360 subtab and access information like the vendor scorecard, which highlights my total number of orders, their combined value, the average days to receive them, and how often the shipments arrive on time. You have view options like open purchase orders, open bills and credits, top purchased items, items returned, and even late purchase orders. We have just walked through the procure-to-pay process and the vendor record at a high level. Thank you for watching. For more information, reach out to your account executive.